the before. This just took like 5 hours of prepping. Ain't that right, baby?
I'm saying, like, why we wanted to start YouTube, like, what we're doing
where's
now.
Where's the girl?
I can't put that on there. I didn't get an Android.
Does the bear look stupid?
No.
Does my hair look okay?
Yes, babe. Oh my gosh.
Stop!
I'm just playing, baby.
Your breath smells
good. I just had gum in it. You must be smelling your breath off my cheek.
Yeah, I guess my breath bounced off of your face.
Yes, it had to, because my breath smells like mint, bro. They saw me spit my gum out.
All right, can we start?
Mm-hmm.
We haven't even, like, talked about this, what we're supposed to say in the beginning.
Nope.
Hey, guys, this is Allie.
And I'm Zach.
And this is Allie and Zach.
It's Allie and Zach. Well, you know, the channel name's A and Z. It was going to be A2Z, but, you know, folks already had that name. And we got
to
be
we looked it up, and we saw that there was already a YouTube couple named A to Z, and they had a good amount of subscribers, and we were like, no, we can't name it that and have the same name as someone else who's already, like, yeah.
So, but, we didn't want to do Allie and Zach, but it does look good.
What do you mean?
Channel name is not Alien Zach, it's ANZ. But you know, our banner says Alien Zach, which is kind of like messed up. It's cropped weird right now, but we're going to fix that. But welcome, guys, to our channel. This is our first video. I am so honored to be on screen with her and so honored to be making YouTube videos and putting out videos for you guys to watch. And you know,
I'm really nervous about this. Like, he has a YouTube with his little brother and his sister.
Shout out to the channel.
But I've never done anything like this. I've always wanted to, but I've always, like, told myself, like, oh, you can never do that. You're too shy. You're too, like, nervous. And I am nervous, but here I am.
So, like she said, she is nervous. She's been talking about it. We've actually planned to make a video for about a month now.
We were supposed to first make the video, and we had planned at the beginning of December to do it, like, on December 9th. But then, like, we've been so busy this month. It's like every weekend
it's
or
Christmas, man. It's
every
Christmas.
Day we had something to do or something to come up, like with class or work, or it was my birthday and then, like, my brother's graduation and then
the camera.
Sorry. And just, like, a lot of stuff we had to get done. And then, like, sometimes we would be like, okay, well, for sure, we're gonna do it tomorrow. So we would have, like, the same off day from work. And then it would come that day, and then something would come up, and we wouldn't be able to do it. But then we finally told ourselves, like, it's about to be 2020, and we don't even have our first video out yet.
I didn't even want to wait till 2020. I wanted to make ours. Like, yeah. I didn't want to be those people to be like, 2020, we starting our YouTube, we first video in 2020. Because, like, people do that all the time, and, you know, like, people make their first video.
People think they have to wait for, like, a new year to start something new. I didn't want to do that. I wanted to have our first video by, like, at the end of 2019, but, like we said, like, we've just been so busy and haven't had time, but we told each other a few days ago, look, New Year's Eve, we're doing it, no matter what, like, no excuses, no matter what comes up.
I was laid out on the floor, sick, throwing up.
Oh, yeah, okay. No, we had actually planned to do it about a week ago.
About a week ago!
And then we both, you know, I got really bad sick, like, I was so sick, I was throwing up. And all types of other stuff. And he was taking care of me that night. Well, he goes home and he gets the same thing I had. I basically gave it to him. He got really, really sick. So we were both sick together. I went to the hospital. He didn't go to the hospital. He got over it really good, but I didn't. We were out of work for like 2 days. I was. But finally, we're better and here we are, finally making our first video.
So guys, today's video is basically, you know, it's a simple video.
It's basically like an intro. We're just going to be talking about like how we met, like what our YouTube's actually going to be about, like what our content's going to be about, what kind of audience we want to reach, and yeah.
All the exciting stuff. But you know, guys, we just want y'all to get to know us, and we want to get to know y'all too, whoever's watching. So like, just, you know, comment down below, talk to us. We'll, of course, reply back. We We love socializing. We love people. And we just want to be able to reach all you guys. Yeah. Guys, first of all, I want to talk about how me and her met. We're going to each give our side
of the story. Our first date. Yeah, you get your side of the story and I'll get my side of the story.
Her side of the story ain't going to be any different because I already know how I do.
That's when you live.
But anyways, so we met at Shelton State.
A lot of people, so like, okay, first of all, we both work at Publix. But a lot of people think that, oh, y'all met at Publix, didn't you? No, we met at Shelton State where we go to college at.
Zach, you can give your side of the story. Cool. But anyways, yeah, we met at Shelton. So I had got out of a relationship about 3-4 months before I even like first saw, like even before I like first talked to her, spoke to her in on the little staircase. So Shelton State is like a community college. So Shelton State, all their classes and like all of the,
it's just one big like building. Everything's put together. The classes are spread out on different ends, but like basically it's all put together.
So I was walking one day, and this is gonna sound cheesy or corny, but you know, I mean, I gotta say it. So I saw her and I just like couldn't stop looking at her, man. I didn't want to be a creep though and just stare. So like I started figuring out which ways that she walked, which ways, where she would sit. She would sit outside with her friend Courtney in the the courtyard at this picnic table every single day, like around 10 or 11, something like that. And I would walk and I'd just look, right? And like nothing creepy or anything. It's just like she was pretty. And like
I never remember like even seeing you.
Cause I'm asleep. But I would walk by and like, you know, I never had the chance to say something to her because I would always be walking to class. And so one day we had been following each other on Instagram.
Yeah, you had followed me like a long time before that.
Yeah, but we didn't know each other. I didn't like see her and it clicked me that I knew that I was following her.
Yeah.
But so anyways, I saw her walking on the stairs one day. She was walking up the stairs and I was walking down. And man, curly hair, so pretty, like curly brown hair, man.
My natural hair is like really, really curly.
Mm-hmm. Really curly, and like she just had a pretty smile. She was smiling. She's always smiling, like when she's out in public, and I love that. She don't smile enough with her teeth, but enough of the little lovey-dovey stuff. But anyways, I saw her, and all we did was say hey to each other, and hey. And so it was a couple weeks after that, on Instagram, I hit her up, or I DM'd her. You know, I slid in.
No, you sent me one of my, like, pictures that I posted. And you commented on it.
Yeah, I sent her one of our pictures. And I had to let her know how good she looked. I used her name. Guys, if you ever gonna compliment a girl, like, if you ever gonna compliment a woman, like, if you use her name, dog, like, that's, like, you addressing her. So that's next level stuff. Because, like, you addressing her with her name. It's not just like, hey, you're so gorgeous. Or, hey, like, it's just some other girl.
Yeah, it was like, you didn't really say much. You were just like, alyy grace. And you put, like, a hard eye. And I like that. Like, it's different than just being like, oh, hey, you're so pretty, or dang, or just like the basic stuff. And when he said that, like, it caught my eye. I was like, oh, okay. But all I said was thank you. And then, like, after that, it was it. I think he added me on Snapchat. And then,
because she used to have her Snapchat.
Yeah. And then added him back. But then after that, like, nothing really happened.
Yeah. After that, for like the next, what? It was like a few months. Like, it was 3 months, 4 months.
Yeah.
Hang on, wait.
Let me tell my side of the story.
Oh, man.
It's not bad. Okay, so before we saw each other on the stairs and said, hey, like, I had no idea who he was. I never noticed him before. I didn't even know he existed. And
yeah, you know how I do, off the radar.
Stop. So, like that day that I saw him on the staircase and we said hey to each other, that's what made me like just notice him and start like paying more attention, like to who I was like surrounded by at school and who would walk past me and stuff. But so like after that, like I said, like we didn't talk, but I would like start seeing him at different places around Shelton. And I know one day me and Courtney, my friend, we were walking in the library. And for some reason, like, this is really strange, but I knew what he looked like from the back of his head. And he was sitting in the library at a computer with, like, this girl that was in his class. And, like, I thought that I looked really bad that day. I had no makeup on. Like, my hair wasn't done. I had on, like, a t-shirt and, like, probably a sweatshirt or something. And I didn't want him to see me. Even though we had never actually talked and I didn't really know him, he didn't know me, but like still, I just didn't want him to see me. So I was like, Courtney, I was like, you see that guy over there? And she was like, yeah. I was like, we cannot walk past him, like he cannot see me. And and she was like, okay. So we walked past him, and like the whole time I'm walking past him, I'm like looking like the opposite way, like to where he can't see my face, even though he did see me. He told me later he did see me. But and then like another day after that, I saw him in the parking lot. Me and Courtney were parked like in the front of like the parking lot of Shelton State, and you were like walking out. And
this was like towards the end of the semester too.
Yeah, and like for some reason he was like looking. He didn't know it was me, but he was like looking into the car. And me and Courtney were like, what is he looking at? And we just started laughing. So, but then he noticed it was us, and he thought that we were laughing at him, but we weren't really laughing at him. We just were laughing just cause like we do stupid stuff. So.
They were laughing at me.
No, we weren't. We didn't even know you.
A few months went by, and like, I really wasn't looking for like a relationship, a committed relationship at the time, of course. Like I wasn't going to pursue something real hard. And like,
I wasn't either.
Yeah, she wasn't either. We would like flirt on and off, and I would hit her up on Snapchat and slide up on her stuff, and you know, and like just text her. Yeah,
I would say thank you, and it would end. And I had just got out of a relationship also, and I just wasn't looking for a relationship.
Yeah. So, anyways, around like the 3 or 4 month period, it was in January. I had been asking her to go to a movie with me. Like I had been wanting her to go to a movie with me or go eat with me. Or something like that, you know, and like we'd always planned to do it, but we never set a date.
You would always ask me, and I would be like, yeah, that's cool, let's do that. And then it would come time, and like we just would never say anything to each other. And then it came to January, which was almost a year ago from now. And he finally asked me, and he was like, hey,
that's after I had called you on the phone, remember? I called you, and I said, Allie Grace. Oh, no, you were. Cause I texted
you. You have to tell him about that time that you asked me to go out, but it didn't work out. And you
I had never got like rejected.
He thought I was lying.
I had never got like, so this is, she stood out because I had never like been told no to go on a date with a female before. And so like when we set a date, we finally got to the point where we set a date. We were going to go on a date. I had it planned out. Like we were going to have a good night. And then I heard some stuff. You know, you can't listen to people. You can't listen to folks tell things because y'all know by now, like, if you get to that age where we at, you know, a lot of people talk, a lot of people spread stuff that's not true and that's, you know, just real messy. And I listened to it. I didn't really know who she was. So, yeah, of course I listened to what, you know, I took it into consideration. And it was the wrong thing to do because I invited her attention and it didn't go too good. We ended up not going out that night. So, like, we finally had the date set, the time. I was literally like, I was about to leave and go get her.
No, let me back up. You had, so like, before we even had the date settled, he had messaged me and asked me about whatever he had heard about me. And what he had heard, like, I had never heard of before. Like, I didn't even know where that came from. I knew the person he was talking about because my friend is, like, friends with him. But I had never heard that before. So I was like, no, like, what are you talking about? And I tried to see where he got it from, and he was just, like, trying to, like, like step around. He didn't want to tell me who he heard it from.
Yeah, because I ain't no snitch.
Yeah, so I messaged the person that he was talking about, and I was like, hey, like, do you know him? Have you been, like, saying stuff to him? Like, what is going on? And he didn't know either. He was like, nah, who is that? And I was like, I don't know. Because I really didn't know him back then. So it kind of settled down, and like it just really like made me mad because I was like, I don't even know you. How are you gonna like come out of nowhere and ask me something like that? And then I tell you no, and then you like act like you're like bothered by it.
Yeah.
Well, so we didn't talk for like a few months, and then finally, he asked me on a date, and we had it planned out, and we were supposed to go to the movies and like go out to eat or something. And it was planned out until, like, the day of. This was really bad on my part, and I felt bad about it. But, I mean, stuff comes up. But, I'd let him know, he messaged me on Snapchat and was like, hey, are we still going? And...
Well, I had never been...
He didn't even have my number.
I ain't even had my number. Yeah, bro, I ain't even had my number. But, like,
I had never been rejected.
And he was like, hey, are we still going? And I was like, oh, something came up. I have to go to my dad's.
And I knew what it was about. Like, I knew it was because of that situation.
Yeah.
I knew it was because
of that. But I really did have to go to my dad's that day. But, like, I was kind of, like, just, like, rejecting him at the same time. But then later, a few months went by. Or a few weeks went by. I don't know. And
it was, like, a week. It was, like, 2 weeks.
Yeah. And he messaged me again on Snapchat. And he was like, Allie, can you call me? And, like, that was, like, after that.
No. I said, Allie. And I said, can I call you? Because I didn't have your number. Yeah. You didn't have my number.
Yeah. Can I call you? Same thing. And so I was like, sure. And I thought, like the way he said it, like, I thought, like, it was about to be about something, like, serious and something else he had to ask me. And, like, I was already, like, in an irritated mood. And I was like, what does this man have to ask me now? So we get on the phone, and I'm trying to see what he wants. And it turns out it was nothing, basically.
Yeah, so we talked for, three, four hours on the phone.
Yeah, we talked. Like, that was the first night we had ever talked on the phone. And when I tell you, like, so I'd been looking at his Instagram pictures, and then I'd seen him in person, of course. But I'd never talked to him. I'd never heard his voice. And when I heard his voice on the first time on the phone, I was so, like surprised. Like, because, like, I don't know. Like, he doesn't look like his voice would be that deep. Like, I didn't think it was going to be, like, high-pitched, but I thought at least it would be, like, a little higher than what it is.
Yeah.
It was like when he answered the phone or when he first said hello, like, I was confused. I thought it was like someone different.
Nah.
I was like, who is this?
Nah, we talked for a little while, and then we did set. We talking about our first day. Nah, we was just trying to talk about how we met. But yeah, so we talked for a while, and I don't even think we set a date that night. We just talked. And then we probably talked again the next night on the phone. And then like the third night or something like that, I probably asked her on a date. Because, you know, I wanted to give her a space. I wanted to, like, I knew that I had to assume something.
I love
don't
space.
Ever assume. If you don't know something, if you didn't hear it from them or you didn't see it, don't ever assume nothing. Because, like, nothing's true until you actually see it in the flesh. And so we set a date and we went on it. And it went great. We can talk about the date on another video because we're getting off track. We're already, like, 20 minutes.
Yeah, later. We're taking way too long to explain this. We forgot, like, certain parts and had to, like, pause, back up, restart, fast forward. But, yeah. Basically met Shelton. We went on our first date in January of 2019, so almost a year ago.
January 15th.
Yeah. We didn't officially start, like, dating, I guess, or, like, officially together, whatever you say, until September 8th. September 8th.
You about forgot it, bro.
No, I didn't.
You almost forgot it. Look, see, she don't pay attention to detail.
September 8th.
My dad's birthday, shout out my pops.
So we're coming up on our 4 months on January 8th. We talked from January till September. And I know that's a long time. That's what, 9 months? I really just, I wasn't ready for a relationship. I was still trying to get over someone else. And yeah. But I finally got over that. And here we are.
Takes a lot of patience, man, to be in a relationship.
Yes. A lot of patience, a lot of
love, a lot of God, you know.
Yes.
God has helped us both out through a lot.
Yeah.
And I feel like God has given me her, like, to get through some other things as well, which is a blessing in itself. So, but let's get on to the next thing. What else we going to talk? Oh, yeah, yeah. So, what our channel, basically, what we want to do with it, for me, like, I have a YouTube channel with my siblings, which I'm going to continue to upload with them. I love my brother and my sister, Madeline and Wes. And we have our own channel of its own. It's called Official Sibs TV. And if you guys want to go check that out too, you can. And it's like, the same thing with that channel. We love making videos, man. It's fun to do. It's fun to video and record things and then see the outcome, like see the product of the video. And just to, like, have people want to watch it is real cool. And that's the same thing with her. Like, I want to be able to reach out to you guys, reach out and just talk to people and entertain people. And it's a passion that I've got, and it would be great to, like, carry on into the future, you know. And
me, like, really, like I said, at the beginning, like, I've never done YouTube. I've never, like, filmed a video for anything. And if you know me personally, you know that I'm a very shy person. I'm not very, like, open.
That's why I'm so surprised. She's talking so much.
No, I'm not. This is nothing. This is just, like, on the surface talking. But Yeah, I mean, basically, like, the purpose of me wanting to do YouTube with him is basically, like, to make memories and then, like, be able to have them, like, on video.
Oh, yeah.
So then, like, 5 to 10 years from now, we can get back on here and look at them and watch them and be like, wow, like, we were so young and we were having so much fun and we did this and we did that. We went here and we said this and even, like, to be able to laugh at ourselves. But, oh, we were so corny or we were so, so
right.
young.
You can see so much growth and... like, just the growth through you, not just YouTube, but, like, with each other and, like, our relationship. And I just feel like there's a lot of people out there that we can reach out to and that we can talk
to. Yeah, and something else, like, I hope, like, if not any, maybe, like, just one person, one day we can give out advice that helps someone with their relationship or even just with themselves or something they're going through or something they're experiencing, just anything.
Right, exactly. And along with that, like, along with what we want to do with our YouTube, now it's not just going to be that, you know. Like, we want to do fun videos. It's going to be fun stuff on our channel. Like, we want to do vlogs and stuff, like, traveling and vlogs. And, like, who knows? We might do pranks on each other in the future. That would be fun. I want to do them. She don't want me to do them on her. But I want to do them. And, like, just surprises and, like, challenges and stuff like that, you know. Like, even in the future, like, workout tips and, like, workout. Because we're both very active in going to the gym when we want to, when we need to get back to it. But, and, like, health tips.
We haven't been very active in the past, month.
I'm not gonna lie to you guys, because I haven't been in the gym in, like, probably a month.
You sure it's been a month?
It might be a little bit longer than a month. But it's been about a month, and I haven't been eating right. But, you know, it's wintertime, it's Thanksgiving, and Christmas.
Yes, like, when it's the holidays, you have you have Halloween, Thanksgiving, and Christmas, New Year's, my birthday, just a lot of stuff that we've been doing. It's, like, every time we want to try to, like, start working out or eating healthy, like,
So, yeah, anytime we want to get to working out or, like, eating healthy or something like that, we got something come up, you know, or something. Like, we just haven't, I haven't personally made it a priority like I should be. I want to get.
I can eat, I'm really good at eating healthy and working out when I want to. I just have to, like, decide when I want to. Yeah. Like, I have to get in my mind, like, oh, Allie, like, you've got to start eating healthy and working out. And once I get it in my head and understand where I have to get my mind at, then I can do it. It's, like, it's easy.
Yeah, there's no excuse, you know. Like, we both know there's no excuses for going or doing. Eating healthy, you know, it's just a mind thing. Oh, by the way, we're filming this on New Year's Eve, guys. So, like, tonight's New Year's. So, happy New Year's to y'all who are watching.
We want to make a video, like, maybe, like, the next week, talking about, like, New Year's resolutions and, like, what we want to do for 2020, what we want to accomplish, goals.
Yeah.
Like, places we want
to
go.
And stuff to help you guys.
Yeah, like, and, like, we give out advice for whoever's watching this and, like, how to help you accomplish your goals and resolutions that you have and...
We're not professionals much, you know.
Yeah, like,
I got a little bit of wisdom to me. You know, we've been on this earth for 20 years, so, you know. I'm just playing.
But. Oh, and I'm 20 years old. I just turned 20, like, 2 weeks ago. And he's 20. He'll be 21 in August.
So, yeah, like I was saying, guys, we've been talking a whole lot. For you guys who don't like all the talking, I understand. I don't like clicking on a video sometimes.
This makes me, like, so nervous. Like, just sitting here being still and, like, looking at a camera and talking. And if you've noticed, like, I haven't been looking at the camera that much because, like, he knows I have a lot of anxiety just from, like, the smallest stuff.
Y'all,
and,
show, like, her some love, man. Show her some. She's been doing good.
I don't need that.
But, yes, you do.
No, we don't.
Yes, you do. But anyway, we actually went to Atlanta this weekend. What was it, Friday night?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we went Friday night. We went to a thing called Botanical Gardens. And it's Christmas time. It's winter. So they had what's called a light show. And it was really cool. She taught me into going. I didn't even know about it. But
actually, okay, so, like, on the way there. So we're from Tuscaloosa, Alabama. We didn't actually mention that. But Atlanta's about 3 hours from here. And...
About 3.5.
About. On the way there, he was like... You asked me something. He was like, how much are the tickets? And, like, I hadn't even, like, looked it up. Like, we had decided to go here, like, 2 weeks before, and I hadn't looked it up since. Like, I hadn't looked up, like, when it starts or the price. We were just going. I was just like, all right. So I get on there, and I look it up, and it says that they're sold out for that night. And we're already, like, 2 hours down the road. We're like an hour away from being there. And, like, he got irritated so fast. He was like, man, what are we going to do?
Nah,
and I was like, Zach, like,
I wasn't irritated because I didn't know what to do because this is Atlanta. I was just irritated because, like, Well, she had originally wanted to go. And so about 2 weeks prior, like, or a week prior before we actually did go, I was like, hey, what are you doing Friday night? Because I was like, let's go to the Atlanta Botanical Gardens like you wanted to. So, like, it was her idea to want to go, but it was my idea to go that night. And so, like, us going and then me finding out that the tickets were sold out, I was like, bro.
And we were already 2 hours down the road. But then I told him, I was like, Zach, like, it's okay. Like, it's Atlanta. There's plenty of stuff you can do. Like, just because that doesn't work out doesn't mean that we can't do something else. And he goes, all right, you're right. And so we get closer and I'm like, you know what? Like, you don't even know, like, it might say it's sold out, but it not might not be, actually be sold out. Let's just drive there and get there in person and see, like, what we can figure out. We get in line, and it turns out they weren't sold out. And by then, it was, like, what, like, 4:30, and we were starving. We hadn't ate all day. We just picked Mexican, which is really basic, because we eat that a lot here. It was but good, though. It was really good.
After that, we went back over to the gardens, and then we went and...
It was so pretty. Like, I'm so glad that we went. I've been wanting to go for, like, 2 years, but, like, I just haven't made time to go or didn't really like, take it that serious that I wanted to go. But the lights were so cool. And like at the end of this video, we're going to drop like a few little clips and pictures for y'all to see.
Nah, they're going to be like a highlight tape. Y'all just watch. It's going to be good. It's okay. Going to have some music too.
I posted like a few little stories on my Instagram, but some of you may have already seen it. I don't know. But we're going to drop a few more so y'all can just see what it looks like. So maybe next year y'all can go and see it.
Guys, we better wrap this one up. We've been talking for a while. My throat getting
dry. I feel like there's something we're missing.
Nah, we can explain it in the next video. Because this one's already about to be 40 minutes. I got to teach her how to edit after this. But, yeah, guys, thank you again for watching. And this is our first video. It's only up from here because we're only going to improve. And
this video, like...
we're going to look back at this about, like, probably... A year
from now, I'm like, oh my gosh. I can already tell that, like, I'm not gonna bed. Like it because I'm, like I said, I'm just so nervous. We're gonna look at how I wasn't looking at the camera and how I was stuttering. And
don't make a New Year's resolution if you're not gonna follow through with it. And don't have a plan B, because if you have a plan B, then you're not gonna follow through with your plan A. So
did you get that off the internet?
Nah, I heard that from somebody who's one of my mentors. All
right.
But yeah, guys, here goes this clip, and then we'll catch you guys in the next one. Cut that shit up, boy.
New car, very noisy. Go to rent and floor. Yeah. You know how I'm coming. You know how I'm coming. Been over, then I'm murdered. Call Gunner if you want your burger. Oh, baby, you be lining your verses. I be here and say you buying them purses. I can't even lie, you ain't my type. You ain't even know that fine in person.
Chip, baby, you look good.
You and me, we both live life full speed, easy to see. When we collide, no one walks away easy.